I have volunteers right now who are finding particular artists' works and then transporting them safely down to the ground floor, which is where the exhibit area will be. We're excited, getting ready for All About Art at Moss Rehab.
The planning of the show is a huge job. It seems to get bigger every year. And Nancy Peugeot, the art consultant, and I do it from soup to nuts. We do everything from the original soliciting of the artist to selecting the art to be in the show, selecting the jurors to award the awards as the show is about to open. We design the hanging of the show, which is a big deal for us. I mean, we think a lot, just as the artists think about composition, we think about composition because, first of all, we love it, and secondly, the art shows better that way, we think. It really highlights the quality of the work. As soon as we put this art up, the hospital comes alive. Everyone is energized by it, and I think as you move through the halls and you see the work and you see both the quality of the work and you then appreciate that it's been done by artists with disabilities on top of that, you can't help but be inspired. It's a very uplifting experience across the board.
This opportunity to have the works of professional artists with physical disabilities here right on campus is just so important. It's inspiring for the staff, it's inspiring for the patients, and I should mention, most importantly, that the artists who exhibit here and Moss Rehab is able to serve as a showcase as well as a marketplace. Each year we have been successful in helping the artists sell more works. The artists have then been able to make money and continue their craft and in a way be employed. Employment and lack of employment is a major issue throughout the country for persons with disabilities. And so we, Moss Rehab, really sees this as an opportunity to help these artists do their work. And, you know, the benefits of having us, the staff, the visitors, other people visit here and see this show is really just wonderful. One of you hold this. I'm going to take you to the elevator. Are you okay with that, Nancy?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to grab you to
the patients in the hospital themselves who, as they see this work and realize that it's been done by artists, some of whom may have the same issues and physical challenges that they themselves are dealing with, we expect that it is also an inspiration to them as well. Some of the artists were artists before they became disabled, and others found new creative abilities within themselves after losing other abilities. Sometimes that's a question of brain function, for example. When a person has a traumatic brain injury, certain areas of the brain may get knocked out. Their math skills may get knocked out, but then they're able to access in another way, for multiple reasons, abilities that perhaps had been quite secondary or not even at their conscious level of conscious awareness. It's not that these people found that they were artistic in art therapy. That's not what happens. It's that other abilities surface.
We find that generally all of the staff are encouraged, and it brings them great joy to see all of this work on the wall. And when they discover what the individual had to go through to create this piece of art, it sort of gives you a second look at what the things that you complain in your life. That I get up today and, oh, this is a bad day, and it really doesn't matter compared to what some of these other people go through day after day. So they're always very pleased and very interested. So it does a lot for everyone who comes to see the show, as well as it does for the artists.
It helps to also change the perception of the public in terms of what it means to have a disability. You're not a disabled person, you're a person with disabilities, as well as a person with great abilities and strengths.